So, yeah, as you said, I'm Britta from Ruhr University Bochum, and thank you again for the opportunity to present some of my results here. I'm doing research on the impact of annual weather fluctuations on output quality and profits of wine producers in Germany. That's the same. For those that are not familiar with German wine regions, you can see that we have 13 wine regions, and they are located in the southwest of Germany, except those from the former eastern parts of Germany, Saale, Unstrut, and Sachsen. They are in this eastern part. And we have 102,000 hectares of land for grape growing. The number of producers, these are numbers from 2010, were 18,700 with more than 5 hectares of land, but we additionally have some small producers, so there are more than, I think, 22,000, Karl will know it better, 22,000 producers. And the yield annually was in 2013 8.3 million hectoliters. More or less the half was exported, but I think more than double was imported as well, because we like to drink wines from other countries as well. The share of white, red, and rosé is about 60% white wine that is grown, and we have about 30% red and 10% rosé. Important grapes are Riesling, that's, I think, well known. Müller-Thurgau, maybe not that well known, and Grauburgunder and Silvaner. There's some special feature in Germany. All the German wines are categorized by the degree of ripeness, and this degree of ripeness is measured in natural grape sugar upon harvest. I don't know exactly how this is done. This is a picture I found, so technically I can't tell you how they measure the sugar content, but maybe one of you can tell me afterwards how this can be done technically. And the higher the sugar content of the grapes used for the wine, the higher up the wine will be categorized. And here you see the different categories in Germany. It starts with the normal table wine, and then it goes up to quality wine, Kabinett, Spätlese, Auslese, Beerenauslese, Trockenbeerenauslese, so we have different quality levels. And if you're lucky, you can, for the different wine regions, not only get data on the total yields, but you can get the yields per quality level. And that's just an example I put here. For example, here, for the Mosel, you can, in 2013, get data on how many hectoliters were of quality wine, Kabinett, Spätlese, and so on, of the different quality levels. This is some of the data I used, but I will tell you later about it. Another thing is that the German wine regions are very close to the northern boundary of commercial grape growing. That means that we depend on highly on favorable weather conditions. And the point is that if the weather varies a lot, yields, that these are the yields, but as well quality and profits vary a lot as well. And if you have a look here at the yields, I will tell you about the data I have a little bit later. You see here the yields for the years 1994 to 2013 for all different wine regions of Germany. And you see that the yields vary a lot. And the same holds for these Oechsle degrees, this sugar content that is measured. And the same holds as well for the profits. But here I have to mention that the profits are only for 5 wine regions, whereas all my other data is for all the 13 wine regions of Germany. These are some picks concerning some of the weather data I have got. I have 10 weather variables. Here, this is only an example. This is the average temperature during the years 1994 to 2013. This is the sum of precipitation for the same years, and this is the sum of hours of sun in the growing period. And you see again that we have a lot of weather fluctuations, and there's not only a big difference between years, but there's a difference between the different wine regions in Germany as well. Just in short, there was already some literature on the impact of weather on yields, on quality, and on profits, but not a lot, I have to admit, and not a lot on German wine regions, and not if there were some research, then it was often focused on one wine region like the Mosel, but there was not literature about an analysis of the weather impacts for all the wine regions. Okay, not working, next one. So I used an extended version of the Ricardian approach. That means I had I tried to analyze my data on yield, on Oechsle degrees, on profits, and additionally on the quality levels, and I as well had share of data on the share of red and white grapes. As a function of climate variables. I have 10 different climate variables, even if I did not use all of them for my regressions, as you will see later. And for the profits, I included a trend as well. And I used regional fixed effects because I assumed that there are some specific time invariant characteristics of the German wine regions that we could see from the charts. And I wanted to control for these time invariant characteristics. So that's in short my data. I got weather data, as you could see from the slides, for the 13 different wine regions from the German weather station. No, it's not the German weather station. Wetterdienst is translation service, the German weather service. And I have average temperatures as well. I have the maximum temperatures, the minimum temperatures. I have minimum soil temperatures and days of frost for the growing periods, and I defined it for March to October. And for the precipitation and the hours of sun, I took the sum and I defined as well one period for the winter before harvest, and I splitted the growing period here into a growing period and a harvest period, but both together can cover the same period I mentioned for the temperatures, so March to October. The annual quantities for each quality level I got from Deutsche Wein Institut. They publish it annually. And I as well had data from the Federal Ministry of Food and Agriculture for the 13 regions. And here I got data on average Oechsle degrees, on yields in hectoliter per hectare, and on the share of red and white grapes. And for the profits, I only could cover 14 years. It was very difficult to get the data. And this data was only published for 5 regions. So here my data is not as good as it is for the other for the other variables. Only short, my descriptive statistics, not that you need to have a look at all the means and standard deviations. I only want to show you that I had a lot of variation in my data. As you can, for example, see for the profit here, you had a minimum for 1 year and region of 1,144 euros per hectare land, and in another year and region it was 7,316. So I had a lot of variation in my data, and the same holds for my weather data. Here you can see my 10 weather variables, and here again you see that I have, of course, the means, but you see that when you look at the data set I had, that there was a lot of variation in the temperature, but if you have a look at precipitation and hours of sun, you as well see, for example here, that in 1 year you had 745 millimeters precipitation, and in another year 1,600. So I had a lot of variation in this data as well. So here are my results, and I can't show you all the things I did because I was trying a lot of things with all my weather variables. I ran a lot of regressions, and so this was a nice fit here when I took for the yields temperature, precipitation in winter and growing, sun in the growing period, and days of frost. And you can see there are some significant, these are in red, some significant coefficients, some are not significant, but altogether higher temperatures led to higher yields. And you see that the other variables only had a slight impact, and this was a negative impact. So there is a big positive impact of temperatures, but only a slight impact of the other variables. When it comes to Oechsle degree, the same temperatures, higher temperatures, have a positive impact on Oechsle degrees. Sun growing as well. Surprisingly, days of frost cannot harm the sugar content. So, but maybe that's because the days of frost are very early in the year and not in August, September, October, I guess. These are my results on the profits, and that's surprisingly as well. There are higher profits if there are higher temperatures. There's a slightly negative impact of sun hours in the growing period. But you see that if I put minimum soil temperatures in the regression, then these soil temperatures have a negative impact. But this disappears when I include the trend. So I included the trend as well. As I said, I tried a lot of things with my data, and then the minimum soil temperature is not significant anymore if I include the trend. And I think in case of profits, it makes sense to include a trend, as I have to cover inflation and price variation as well. Just in short, 0 minutes. Okay, I'm nearly done. There's a slight shift to red varietals due to temperature, to higher temperatures. And this was a little bit, I will discuss it with my colleagues afterwards. I had some difficulties in interpreting this result. But I think here the qualities, this is the share of quality levels I had, and they depend on each other. That means when there is higher temperature, maybe I have, as you can see here, more quality wine cabinet, but more Beerenauslese and so on as well. But you don't never know if the negative impact comes from the left or the right side, because there's a dependency, and so I think I have to think about what I can do with this data next. That's the last slide I've got. I just made an estimation what if due to climate change there will be increase in temperatures of 2 degrees, and if I only have a look at the temperatures, average yields will rise by 20.3%, Oechsle degrees will rise by 6.8 degrees, and average profits, only including the temperature, not the minimum soil temperature, by 44%. And you see, if I have some additional assumptions, so I have different scenarios how the climate will be in Germany during the next decade, and so I can use the model in order to estimate the effects on yields and quality and profits. And what Tony said in the morning, I think even if there is climate change leading to higher degrees, you have a lot of weather fluctuations. And if higher temperatures of 2 degrees mean an increase, for example, in profits of 44%, then a year with a 2 degree temperature less, this means you have a decrease in profits of the same height. And this causes a lot of problems for German wine growers as well. So I'm done. Thank you for listening.